Welcome back to Rise of Three Kingdoms, as I continue to play this rather incredible mod. Now maybe I'm just ignorant of other mods, since most of my time has been spent playing games like Third Age Total War and the like, but this legitimately has impressed me. I don't want to build roads here. What am I doing? Take two. This mod has managed to legitimately impress me, though, because there's just something so cool about it. There really is. There's all sorts of new features that I know I've been using other mods before, and even some variations I'm pretty sure are present in Third Age Total War. But at the same time, I get very little opportunity really to really kind of do these sorts of things. To see these details. If only because I've been spending so much time playing Third Age Total War. So let's see, small market. Despite the chaos and increasingly frequent wars, the people of the Three Kingdoms era have carried on the tradition of bringing local produce to nearby towns and counties to barter for daily necessities. The markets also played a secondary role in relaying information. As a result of the deeply ingrained cultural practice of trade and barter, the economy usually recovered quickly after the wars. Okay. Good to know. Right, let's build some markets. Let's get ourselves an increased income. I mean, we already get enough money, but it's like more money is always a good thing. No, can't really get around that. Good, more money is always going to be a good thing. Let's see, beat up armies. Let's see. Here's Zhe Rong with his remnant here, heading back to Huijai. I don't know.
You will have no right.
Regardless, Yan Yu will avenge him.
You are my prisoner.
Yeah, no peasant volunteers. Let's see. Actually, no, I got the money for it. So let's bolster our force slightly.
Charming Green.
Then march here, I think.
Kaishan.
All right, Gunning and Han Dong. Right, camp raiders are really dangerous. Got to be careful of them. And let's see, Hung Dong. His force isn't too scary. It's got some dangerous troops there, but it'll be okay, I think. Hold out baits to entice the enemy. Feign disorder and crush him. Or Book 1. Still a book I have to read. I really should, given that I'm pretty fascinated by military history. It's just I never really had the opportunity. Maybe I should change that, eh? Let's get people in a guard mode. Start the battle.
Our feeble foe brings more men to
the enemy's coming from here.
They will gain
there
only more widows.
They'll only gain more widows. Okay. No, now they're starting to move. I was wondering if they're just going to hold there or not, but now they're starting to move. Now. Are they going to try to reposition on me, though? That's the question. Or are they going to advance to the end? Let's speed it up a little to find out. They're advancing still. Oops, didn't mean to pause it. He's got a lot of cavalry in this force. Ah, crap. They're advancing already. I'm in guard mode this time, so hopefully it'll help a bit against bracing against those cavalry attacks.
Ah, shit. Oh, God. Whoa, God. What? Oh, those swordsmen, that's why. Those light horsemen hit them pretty hard for being in guard mode. I'll be perfectly honest with you right there. They hit really hard for them being in guard mode. Ah, crap. Crap, they already broke one of my units. I didn't... Shoot.
Our soldiers must be fighting like old women.
Ah, crap. This is not going to end well for me.
Like a bee around a blossom.
And shoot the camp raiders, doesn't matter who's there. Oh, gosh. I wasn't expecting those cavalry charges to be so effective, though. Thought they'd be I really did think they'd be a little less effective than they were. You know, that was... I don't know. I don't know how I feel about that, actually. I thought the cavalry charge would be a lot less effective than it was.
Only half the enemy force remains between us and victory.
Can I just get rid of Gun Ning? We surrounded him with our cavalry force. Shoot. Where's the rest of the enemy force? I should have gone to shield wall formation instead. That's what I should have done. Well, at least the archers are getting rid of the camp raiders there.
Our brave warriors have killed our foe's general. Now his men will fear us.
Hold on, gotta deal with that now. Okay. See what's going on. Where's my archers? There they are. What are these guys doing? Come on.
Only half of our force remains.
Why are these guys split up so much? What the hell? Oh, he's dead. Okay. Pull back. Oh gosh, we're not gonna have an army after this. That sucks. Ah, crap. He still has Hundong has a group of cavalry there. He has three archer groups, so I could destroy him pretty easily. I just need an opening. That's all I need. Shoot the heavy cavalry now. Just stop moving and shoot. Alright, let's start wrapping around now. Move these two units and these Zhongdong archers, or however you pronounce it, I don't know how to pronounce it. Leave me alone. Get the rally call there. My units are routing.
are crushing our enemy. Those fools cannot stand against us.
Gonna pursue the general's bodyguard here. We're gonna shoot them now because the spearmen have just reached them. Alright. Alright, let's pull back a bit. Surprised the archers don't break faster than this, though. I mean, it's not like we're not massacring them or anything, you know?
Only half the enemy force remains between us and victory!
Shooting our own men here, but gotta get rid of these enemies somehow. What's going on here? Broke them. Alright, broke them. I've taken so many casualties now, I'm just gonna have to retreat. Oh crap, more of Jungdong archers. What the hell?
Hunt them down.
Alright, seriously guys, just stop running at this point and shoot them. Seriously, they're right in front of your frickin' faces. Right there, and you're just not doing anything. I mean, really—that skirmish mode—that was annoying. They're being pursued by cavalry. Why didn't they just stop? Don't they stop after a point? Why does that not kick in this time of all times? That doesn't make any sense. Okay, what's going on here? We get the archers. They're almost gone. They break? Yes, they broke. All right, I need to get these swordsmen over here now. Because they are one of the last few threats we're facing. Nope, wrong unit, there we go. Right unit. There's the enemy general with his what the? Oh, he was... He's stabbing really weird with that spear. Oh god, stop shooting! Don't shoot! Don't shoot! Okay. Go for it. I just realized these are heavy cavalry. Crap. I took a lot of losses for losing heavy cavalry there. Alright, gonna have to do it again.
We are crushing our enemy. Those fools cannot stand against us. Our brave warriors
finally
killed our foes' general. Now his men will fear us. See the enemy all right. Run before our might.
Let me just mop up this one unit real quick. There's the other orphans. One out there. I'm gonna... Let's get a General's Bonnegard on that. Where is it? I can't see it from this distance. Where's the unit? Unit, there you are. It's like two people, but let's get him. All right.
Great victories like this go to only the greatest.
All right. Sorry if I got a little quiet there, as usual. But I tend to get quiet when I'm focused. You know that. 547 casualties. Ugh, gosh. Ransom? They accept it again. Unfortunately, my army's in shambles here now, so... I can't move it anymore.
Struggle if you like.
Don't like that.
your lungs, and women, regardless.
It's the Iron Wall. Okay. Ah, darn it, Skype. Really? They have been messaging all day, and now they message now.
My mother will reward me for your death.
Really? They message now.
Is it your brother?
Right.
Struggle if you like.
I'm trying to figure out what to do. I'm not sure what to do.
Harassing me will not help matters.
Yes, you guys can march. Ha, there it is, Lin Hai. Okay, so we'll take that, get ourselves some new territory.
Let's
see. Liu Wu, right. Liu Wu, save. Maintain the siege. They have 8 turns until they surrender. Okay, it looks like they merged a bunch of units when we weren't looking. 8 turns. Should I wait 8 turns or take it, though? I don't know. The thing is that I don't know how far Sun Clan territory extends. Okay, so that's not their territory. They're not across the river. I'm not sure what other territory they control, though. Of course, I have to get rid of these two armies, too. How is that possible? It's not possible. What? This is in their zone of control. How can I possibly move here through that path? Doesn't make any sense.
Hey,
guys, I'm going to merge these two armies because I need numbers. It's a numbers game at this point. Sun Chun, Chief of Yangxian, and let's see, what is he? He's a faction leader. Okay, so he's the replacement. He's a new faction leader. He's got a big cavalry force next to him, and the faction trainer Zhang Qin. Okay, we got a lot of cavalry in this enemy attack, in this enemy force again. But I'm not going to be stupid this time about my formations. And I got a lot of peasants, so the peasant's going to do what peasant's going to do, you know? They're going to get slaughtered, but whatever. Start deployment! Alright, good. This is exactly what I planned. High ground. High ground means I don't have to worry so much about my defense. Because the enemy is at a disadvantage. Yeah, if they try to charge uphill at me, they're gonna suffer for it. Archery followed by the fact that they just can't hit me with speed from uphill, or charging uphill, alright. So let's get the two largest general's bodyguards and one of these. Let's get the largest general bodyguard in one of these. Put them here. And let's get the smaller two in one of these. And leave them here. Start battle.
The enemy bring more lambs to the slaughter. So be it. We will slaughter more lambs.
Your penchant for being punny is not appreciated, sir. It's not appreciated at all. No, that's not plan, it's a metaphor. Pension for metaphor! That was the word I was thinking of. Metaphor. Metaphor. Shouldn't move as a group. We're gonna move downhill slightly because we still got the upslope. We still got the upslope, and it's a steep upslope, so. Is the other enemy army really far off the map right now? Because I can dig that. No, I can dig that a lot. Alright, let's start marching them. Guys can march up here. There's Skype again. I'm sorry, guys. I should have turned it off. Too bad. Now you're going to look at your Skype things until you realize that... Hey, wait a second. Wait, that's his Skype. Jerk. Actually, the right is not a good angle for the cavalry, so... We're going to position all the cavalry over here. And now we're going to super speed this. Would you like to super size that? No, I'd like to super speed it, though. All right, Han volunteers. They're closest, so we're going to start shooting at them. Wait, we're almost in range of these horsemen. Please stop moving! You're in range of the damn horsemen! Jeez. You just keep moving sometimes. I hate that. I hate that so much. Okay, you're not all shooting. I don't know why. So let's reset that. Let's attack the enemy general's bodyguard. This is right in the middle of their formation, and thus they'll suffer the most for it. In fact, we're still killing more Han volunteers than anything else. Back behind the line. I'll move the cavalry en masse. No skirmish mode for the archers. Guard mode enabled, though. Alright, they charged, but as I thought, their momentum was blunted. We're taking losses, but that's okay. Oh, we're taking a lot of losses on the one unit. Okay, let's move that group. Let's move this group. Let's do this! Kill them all!
We have bled the enemy badly. They have only half their men left.
Surround them utterly and destroy them. Right, let's get you guys going. Okay, they broke. Alright, let's charge uphill on their backs, though. So that we still have the advantage. Let's start moving the archers. My infantry's shredded, though. Well, my one infantry unit's shredded. Okay, apparently I can't get these archers moved. So we'll just shoot the Jingdong cavalry as they...
Our enemy. Those fools cannot stand against us. The enemy king has died in battle.
Yes!
The king should. Make sure his subjects join him. See the enemy run before our might. We will leave nothing behind but widows and orphans.
Let them run away, it's okay. Oh, they can run toward us, that works too. What the hell? What are these guys doing up here? I didn't tell them to move there at all. What? Gosh, this game's pathfinding, I swear. If it could make any less sense, it really couldn't make any less sense. It just slaps people wherever the hell it wants. It's annoying as heck. It's like, oh, I have a brilliant strategy. Nope. Don't feel like going there. It's like, screw you, game. guys. Come on, archers, reposition. You guys are still being a pain in the butt. Come on, over here. What are the archers doing? The archers aren't positioning right either. What the heck? This is Medieval 2, though. This is not like some sort of game balance issue. This is Medieval 2. It's always kind of been a thing. It's just really frustrating when you're someone like me. Is the enemy falling back or what? I can't tell. It looks like they're pulling back because we defeated the other army first, early on. Something I don't know. Alright, let's run the archers over because it doesn't matter if they're exhausted or not, really. They'll probably shoot less accurate if they're exhausted, but it's a less of a point than if they're, I wonder if I can replenish my forces in towns even though I'm at my recruitment limit. I have no idea, so that's why I'm asking. Which is why I'm wondering. Come on, I can move here. Why can't I do the... There we go. Stupid thing. Jeez. So obviously, like, deformed terrain is a problem in this game. A very irritating problem. And when I say very, I mean incredibly irritating. I mean, this is ridiculous. I can't seem to position anything properly because of this right now, so... guys, can you get the rest of your dudes up here, maybe? Okay, there they go. The heck? Why are you moving up to meet them? Just stand still, you dumbasses! This game's pathfinding's so terrible sometimes. I mean, there is no conceivable reason they should be running around in a completely illogical fashion. Like, no conceivable reason for that. Yeah, let's shoot at the cavalry, actually. The cavalry's always gonna be more dangerous. They're pretending to shoot! Like the orcs! Come on, guys. Let's stop doing this crap. I'm not shooting anything. Stop doing that! What the hell? I'm really getting... These are engine bugs, and they're really irritating engine bugs. Now, what I need right now are archer volleys. And I'm not getting archer volleys! The enemy's advancing, and I'm not getting archer volleys! Come on! Have I taken a lot of casualties due to this? This game... It's really gonna start. The game itself is just gonna start wearing thin, because, jeez, this is retarded. It really is. It doesn't make any ding dong damn sense. I'm still watching way too much Markiplier. All right, let's try this again, without the shooting blanks, please. There we go. Finally, some arrows.
We are crushing our enemy. Those fools cannot stand against us.
Oh,
Only half the enemy force remains between us and victory.
Yeah, I know I'm quiet again. Shush, people. Shush, people. I'm making sure that I don't get massacred. Because, gosh, massacres are happening a lot in this game. Like, I don't know if I'm just being excessively careless or what. It's just, I've been losing men left and right this game. And it's only the second turn! It is literally only the second turn!
Come on, let's start wrapping this one up.
Is that the enemy general? He has a cape. Must be him. Why is he humping his? What is he doing?
See how our foe hovers around victory like a bee around a blossom.
What is he doing? What is he doing? He's like popping off his horse, like humping the saddle periodically, and then just doing whatever. I don't know what he's doing. It's creepy.
Can we shoot these guys, maybe? Maybe? Seems like an idea.
Yeah, this was a good idea, in fact.
Where's the enemy general? Gone off to? Should be right here, right? What's he doing? Ah, there's his group. Okay, it's still in the middle of my horsemen. There he is. Let's get him with archers.
I'm going to break off here because these guys are fighting to the death and I don't want to take unnecessary casualties because they're fighting. There's only five of them left. But...
Our brave warriors yes! killed our foe's general. Now his men will fear us.
Or they can just kill him. Okay, that works too.
Our foe is
all right. There's only one enemy unit left, so let's just end it now.
Only the greatest of men!
Greatest of men! Hurrah! My lord's military power is divine, spans the four corners of the world. Those who submit first will be given great rewards. Shang Liao enticing Chang Zi to surrender. Chang Shi to surrender. Okay. Execute! I'm done letting them live. Now they shall die by my hand. I didn't check my casualties. I suppose because it's made me cry enough over the past few episodes of the things I've played. What's the status? Full supply. Okay, still got full supplies.
Puva,
okay, where are we going? This is all the Hongshuang district, so.
Puva.
Crap, I should have sent him this way. Darn it. Oh, wait, you can go this way. Woo! Okay, perfect. Yan Yu might be in danger. Depends on what Pan Zhang's unit force is made up of. Okay, so he's got mounted Puchu.
Struggle if you like. I will take.
Who's their new leader, I wonder? Because I've killed their king twice, two turns in a row now.
Let's
see, there was another guy. Oh, I guess not. Oh, I was thinking about this guy here? I don't know. I'm going to send a diplomat this way, though, to get another one of those unaligned generals. Alright, so anyway, I've been playing for way too long. So thank you all for watching. I hope you're enjoying Rise of Three Kingdoms. And I will catch you next time as we continue to fight for China. Until next time, everyone.